स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फ्रॉम केवी राय अकेडमी। आई एम अरुण पांडे। आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे क्लास 10 सब्जेक्ट बायोलॉजी चैप्टर 1 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज लाइफ प्रोसेसेस। बट इनसाइड चैप्टर 1 लाइफ प्रोसेसेस वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस विथ यू एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस इन प्लांट्स एंड रिस्पायरेशन इन रूट्स, रिस्पायरेशन इन स्टेम्स and respiration in leaves today. So first of all, I am going to discuss exchange of gases in plants. So exchange of gases in plants, that means in plants, every part such as leaves and stem respire. In plants, every part such as leaves and stem respire. That means plants respire with the help of leaves and with the help of stem also. But oxygen is obtained from the atmosphere through stomata in leaves. Oxygen is obtained from the atmosphere. Oxygen is obtained from the atmosphere through stomata. Stomata is present in the leaves. And in stem, there is lenticels that will help in exchange of gases. In stems, lenticels are present and that lenticels are help in the respiration process in plants. But in stems and by root hair, in the root of the plants, there is root hair and that root hair help in the respiration process. So the large intercellular space, large intercellular space keep the plant cell in contact with air. So the large intercellular space keep the plant cells contact with air. The large intercellular space, so that you do present in large intercellular space, plants will be contact in air. Now it will be from the atmosphere. Exchange of respiratory gases. Exchange of respiratory gases, that means carbon dioxide and oxygen. Exchange of respiratory gases, that will oxygen and carbon dioxide in plant take place by the process of diffusion. So exchange of respiratory gases in plants, exchange of respiratory gases, respiratory gases means oxygen and carbon dioxide, took place in plant by the simple diffusion process. By the process of diffusion, it took place in the plants. So, in diffusion, the movement of molecules of a solute from region of higher concentration to a region of lower concentration took place. So, inside the process of diffusion, exchange of gases out from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration took place. So the diffusion, the movement of molecules of solute from regions of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration took place. The direction of diffusion depends upon the environmental condition and temperature of the plant. That means whatever will be environmental condition of the plant and temperature will be plant, that will affect the rate of diffusion. So at night, what happens? At night when photosynthesis does not occur. At night when photosynthesis does not occur, carbon dioxide elimination occurs as the major activity. When at night, when the photosynthesis does not occur, photosynthesis does not complete at night, so carbon dioxide elimination is the major activity in the plant body. So during the day, carbon dioxide generated during respiration is for the photosynthesis. In the daytime, carbon dioxide generated by the living organism is used in the process of photosynthesis. Then what happens? There is no release of carbon dioxide. Instead, release of oxygen is a major event during the day. Release of oxygen is a major event during the day, and the releasing of or exchange of carbon dioxide is a major event at night. So this is my explanation about exchange of gases in plants. So after this, I am going to explain respiration in roots. So in the process of respiration in roots, the roots of plant are fixed in the soil. The roots of plants are fixed in the soil. I am telling that respiration in roots. So respiration in roots, that will be inside the topic respiration in roots. The roots of a plant are fixed in the soil. Everybody know that, you all very well know the roots of the plant are fixed in the soil. So the fine air spaces present between the soil particle contain oxygen. So fine air particle. So fine air spaces present between the soil particles. So I am simply tell you that spaces present in the particle of soil contain air. So this oxygen is taken up by the root hair through the by the diffusion. Once again, try to understand. The root of the plant are fixed in the soil. The fine particle of soil contain oxygen, and this oxygen is taken by the root through the process of diffusion. So the root hair are simple extension of root. Root hair, I am telling the body root hair. The root hair are simple extension of the roots which don't have waterproofing cuticle. That means root hair have not any waterproofing cuticle. Because of this, oxygen diffuses into the root hair. Because the absence of waterproofing cuticle, the oxygen diffuses into the root hair and reaches the epidermal cell. Because in the absence of waterproofing cuticle, oxygen diffuses into the root hair. Oxygen take entry inside the root hair and reaches the epidermal cell of the root, from where it passes into the other cell. Then from the root hair, this oxygen passes and take entry into the other cell. Similarly, carbon dioxide from the epidermal cell. Similarly, in the same way, carbon dioxide from the epidermal cell of the root, from where it passes into the cells. Similarly, carbon dioxide from the epidermal cell of the root moves back into the air spaces. Carbon dioxide moves back into the empty air spaces and then to the soil through root hair, so the exchange of gases took place in the roots through the root hair. So by this process, carbon dioxide and oxygen both exchange by the root hairs in the plants. So after that, I am telling you and going to explain you respiration in distance. So how it took place? Respiration in distance. Small plants like herbs have green stem which contains a small number of stomata. Small plants that are called herbs have contains a small number of stomata. As you know, stomata are small pores present in the leaves of the plants. So these stomata are found in green plant that is called a herb, in number of various stomata are found. Then exchange of gases took place in stems through these stomata. Exchange of respiratory gases took place in the stomata also. So in woody plants, the stem is covered with bark. In woody plants, that means large trees, has special structure that is called bark, and stem is covered inside the bark. So the lenticels are present on the bark. Lenticels present on the bark, through which exchange of gases occurs between stem and atmosphere. So as you know, in stem, exchange of respiratory gases will take place by the lenticels. Lenticels are present in the stem. So lenticels are the respiratory organ in woody plants, in stem. So after this, am going to explain you about respiration in leaves. Then how it took place in leaves. So in respiration in leaves, the exchange of respiratory gases in leaves took place through stomata by the process of diffusion. By the process of diffusion, exchange of respiratory gases will took place. So stomata are made up of two semicircular gourd cells. Stomata are made up of two semicircular gourd cells surrounding the central pore. Stomata, once again try to understand. Stomata are made up of two semicircular, not fully circular, semicircular gourd cell which is surrounded the central pore. Oxygen diffuses in through the stomata and reaches the leaf cell, and carbon dioxide diffuses out of the leaves. So with the help of stomata, oxygen will also diffuses out and carbon dioxide also diffuses inside the plant body. Then when carbon dioxide concentration in the cell increases, when carbon dioxide, that means concentration of carbon dioxide will be increases inside the cell, the stomata open and the carbon dioxide released into the atmosphere. Once again, this line I am telling you, and once again I explain you that when carbon dioxide concentration in the cell increases, when carbon dioxide concentration in the cell increases, then stomata opens and carbon dioxide released into the atmosphere. So this is my explanation about exchange of gases in plants, respiration in roots, respiration in stems, and respiration in leaves. I think that this much enough.